हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट रिस्क मैनेजमेंट अंडर द प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट। वी ऑल नो डेट रिस्क इज द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ लॉस और इंजरी। प्रोजेक्ट रिस्क इज एन अनसर्टन इवेंट और कंडीशन डेट इफ इट इज अकर हैज एन इफेक्ट ऑन एटलीस्ट वन प्रोजेक्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव। रिस्क मैनेजमेंट फोकस ऑन आइडेंटिफाइंग एंड असेसिंग द रिस्क टू द प्रोजेक्ट एंड मैनेजिंग दोज रिस्क टू मिनिमाइज द इम्पैक्ट ऑन द प्रोजेक्ट। Now, what is risk management on project? Risk management can mean different things on different type of projects. Project risk management is the process of identifying, analyzing, and then responding to any risk that arise over the life cycle of a project to help the project remain on track and meet its goal. Risk management is not reactive only. It should be part of the planning process to figure out risk that might happen in the project and how to control that risk if it in the fact occurs. A risk is anything that could potentially impact your project's timeline, performance, or budget. Risks are potentialities, and in a project management context, if they become realities, they then become classified as issues that must be addressed. So risk management then is the process of identifying, categorizing, prioritizing, and planning for the risk before they become issue. Now, what is positive risk? So not all risk is created equally. As mentioned, risk can be either positive or negative. Though most people assume risks are inherently the latter, where negative risk implies as something unwanted that has the potential to irreparably damage a project. Positive risks are opportunities that can affect the project in beneficial ways. Negative risks are the part of your risk management plan, just as positive risk should be. But the difference is in approach. You manage and account for non-negative risk to nature their impact. But positive risk can also be managed to take full advantage of them. There are many examples of positive risk we can find in construction projects. So you could complete the project early and you could acquire more customer than you concerned for. Now, 6 steps in the risk management process. So how do you handle something as seemingly elusive as project risk management? The same way you do anything when managing a project, you make a risk management plan. It's all about process. So process can make the unmanageable manageable. You can take what look like a disadvantage and turn it into an advantage if you follow these 6 steps. These steps are: identify the risk, analyze the risk, prioritize the risk, assign an owner to the risk, respond to the risk, and monitor the risk. So what is identify the risk? This is the first stage of risk management. So you can't resolve a risk if you don't know what it is. There are many ways to identify risk. As you do go through this step, you will want to collect the data in a risk register. One way is brainstorming or even brain writing, which is a more structured way to get a group to look at a problem. As noted earlier, you can tap your resources. That can be your team, colleague, or stakeholders. Find those individuals with relevant experience and set up interviews so you can gather the information you will need to both identify and resolve. It doesn't hurt to speak with that person in your organization who is the glass is always half empty type. Their doom and gloom perspective can be helpful to see risk that might not be evident to everyone else. So look both forward and backwards. That is, imagine the project in progress, think of the many things that can go wrong. Note them, do the same with historical data on the past project. Now your list of potential risks has grown. Analyze the risk. So you have got a lot of potential risk listed in your risk register. But what are you going to do with them? The next step is to determine how likely each of those risks are to happen. This information should also go into your risk register. When you assess project risk, you can ultimately and proactively address many impacts, such as avoiding potential litigation, addressing regulatory issues, campaign with new legislation, reducing your exposure and minimizing impact. How do you analyze risk in your project? Through quantitative and qualitative risk analysis. Of course, what does that mean? It means you determine the risk factor by how it impacts your project across a variety of metrics. Those rules you apply are how the risk influences your activity, resources, duration, and cost estimates. Now prioritize the risk. So some risks are going to require immediate action. Not all risks are created equally. You need to evaluate the risk to know what resources you are going to assemble towards resolving it, when and if it occurs. Some risks are going to be acceptable. You would grind the project to a head and possibly not even be able to finish it without first prioritizing the risk. Having a large list of risks can be daunting, but you can manage this by simply categorizing risk as high, medium, or low. Now there is a horizon line and you can see the risk in context. With this perspective, you can begin to plan for how and when you will address this risk. Assign an owner to the risk. All your hard work identifying and evaluating risk is for naught if you don't assign someone to oversee the risk. In fact, this is something that you should do when listing the risk. Who is the person who is the responsible for that risk, identifying it, when and if it should occur, and then leading the work towards resolving it. Think about it. If you don't give each risk a person tasked with watching out for it and then dealing with resolving it, when and if it should arise, you are opening yourself up to more risk. It's one thing to identify risk, but if you don't manage it, then you are not protecting the project. Now responding to the risk. Now the rubber hits the road, you have found a risk. For each major risk identified, you create a plan to mitigate it. You develop a strategy, some preventative plan. You then act on the risk by how you prioritize it. You have communications with the risk owner and together decide on which of the plan you created to implement to resolve the risk. Now, the last stage of risk management is monitor the risk. So you can't just set forces against a risk without tracking the progress of the initiative. That is where the monitoring comes in. Whoever owns the risk will be responsible for tracking its progress towards resolution. But you will need to stay updated to have an accurate picture of the project overall progress to identify and monitor new risks. So you will want to set up a series of meetings to manage the risk. Make sure you have already decided to make the means of communication to do this project, it is best to have various channels dedicated to communication. So you can have face-to-face meetings, but some updates might be best delivered by email or text or through a project management software tool. So whatever you choose to do, remember, always be transparent. It is best if everyone in the project knows what is going on, so they know what to be on the lookout for and help manage the process. So here we can understand the stages of risk management and can control the different type of risk in our construction projects. So thanks for watching.